An ayahuasca journey is a complex and difficult process. First off, there's the physical effects. Ayahuasca is a beverage. It's a brew, and it tastes absolutely disgusting. It is hard to imagine a more horrific and unpleasant taste. And you have to brace yourself physically and mentally before pouring this beverage down your throat. I certainly do. It's very, very, very hard work. Secondly, within about half an hour to an hour of drinking the brew, most of us start to feel pretty ill. You're vomiting, you have diarrhea. It's a most physically a most uncomfortable ordeal that you have to go through before the powerful visionary effects to begin to take place. And those visionary effects typically have two levels. One of them concerns what you might call personal development. You know, in the Amazon, they believe that there is an intelligent spirit that lies behind ayahuasca. They don't think they're dealing with just plants, and who are we to say they're wrong? The shamans believe that an intelligent entity, a spirit being, lies behind the ayahuasca beverage, and that she, and they always regard her as a female presence, that her business is the planet and the betterment of human beings. Strange idea, huh? But this is what they believe in the Amazon, and they know a damn sight more about it than we do. Well, one of the ways this works is that ayahuasca will typically show you your own life in an extremely clear and unconfused way. You know, normally we protect our own behavior with all sorts of little personal explanations and reasons for why we behave in the way that we do. Ayahuasca will show you absolutely clearly and honestly really why you behaved in the way that you did. Sometimes you may have been mean or harsh to another person and pass that off as absolutely the right thing to do under the circumstances. Ayahuasca will show you it was the wrong thing to do. It will show you that anger and ego and arrogance and pride in your own personality are not serving you and are not helpful. And it will keep teaching you these lessons again and again and again, showing you starkly and honestly how you are until you start fixing your behavior and improve the way that you function in the world and work hard to become a less toxic and more positive person. Ayahuasca's done this for me, and it's done it for countless other people who I know. It's a mystery, but there it is. It puts you through that psychological process where you actually start examining your own life and asking questions about the way you behave. The second thing that ayahuasca does is take you on a journey into parallel realms. Now, of course, many scientists would say this is just brain candy. This is just an illusion of your own brain, disturbed brain chemistry. I don't agree with those scientists. I can't prove they're wrong, but when I look at the burden of evidence, and particularly of the huge body of knowledge that shamanistic cultures have brought together on the use of visionary plants, I'm inclined to believe that they're right, and that reality is much more complicated than we imagine, and that we are surrounded all the time by a vast, invisible reality, normally invisible to our senses. And what I found, and many others report this with ayahuasca, is that it seems to retune the receiver wavelength of the brain and allow those normal, invisible realms to become visible for a brief period. So it connects us to a much wider reality. This can be deeply disturbing, but also incredibly nourishing, to realize that we are not just this finite little dot; that we're part of a much huger and wider and awe-inspiring reality. And the third thing that happens with ayahuasca, and it's very curious, is that if you have some aspect of your life that's creative, could be writing poetry, could be painting, ayahuasca again and again will enhance that, All over the world now, we're seeing incredible visionary art produced by people who've been inspired by ayahuasca. Now, this is not news to the shamans in the Amazon, because they create incredible visionary art and have done for thousands of years, documenting their ayahuasca journeys. But it's happening in the West now. I'm thinking of people like Alex Gray, Bob Vinosa, Martina Hoffman, who have brought into being incredible works of art inspired by their ayahuasca experiences. It seems to enhance certain aspects of human creativity. All of these things are available to us should we choose to drink ayahuasca. We do not have to drink ayahuasca. It's a personal choice. I would like to live in a society where that personal choice can be made free of fear, free of ideology, free of propaganda, simply a decision that an adult makes about his or her own life. I'm not claiming that I'm a better person because of ayahuasca, but what I am saying is I'm trying to be a better person because of ayahuasca. It's showed me serious faults in my personality. I regard them as serious, which need to be fixed. And life is a journey, and I'm 59 years old, and I only have, you know, so much longer on this planet. And with the time I have left, I would like to do it right rather than do it wrong. And I'm grateful to ayahuasca for showing me where I've been doing things wrong. It's very hard to change deeply ingrained old habits, but I am trying, and I shall continue to try while I'm on this planet. In terms of my